Hi, my name is Jason Kimes. I'm with Standard Equipment Company. Today we're going to go over the winterization of the Elgin Whirlwind Street Sweeper. Now, first thing you need to do is park your unit on a nice flat surface. Make sure to put it in neutral and set the parking brake. The first step after placing your truck on a nice level platform is locating your water tank drain. On this unit, it's found right here. I'm going to remove the plug and let all the water drain out of the system. Once you have removed the water tank drain and all of the water is released from the water tank itself, come over to the driver's side of the unit and locate your water filter housing. Now, before removing the filter, make sure that your bypass valve is in the open position. Once you have done so, remove your filter housing and internal screen. Make sure you clean the screen and put both filter housing and screen in a storage location for the winter. If your unit is equipped with an air purge system, the air purge valve will be located along with the water filter housing. If your unit does have this option, get your shop air hose and connect to the port and slowly open the manual valve. Once you have done so, go ahead and turn your water pump on for a few moments. This will help in getting all the water out of the system. Continue this until no water is coming out of the spray nozzles. Once you have done so, turn off your water pump, close your air purge valve, and disconnect airline. Please make sure that if using shop air, the shop air does not exceed 100 PSI. Once you have done these steps, remove filter and filter housing and place in cab or in storage. If your unit is equipped with a PM10 water pump, find the water pump and open the drain valve here. Now, you do want to drain both low pressure water pumps. Any water that is left in pumps during cold temperatures can freeze and damage the pump. The next step is to remove the cap on the water fill. Now, I've already done so and already placed the cap in the cab for storage. Now, at this time, one thing you always want to double check is to make sure that the antifreeze in both engines will be up to temperature ratings for the weather that is coming. After you have made sure that both low pressure water pumps are emptied, come back to the rear of the unit and empty your high pressure washdown pump. This can be done very easily just by opening the drain valve right here located on the side of the pump. This time you're going to want to drain any water from the fuel water separator. Once you have done so, securely close the valve. Also, windshield washer fluid. Sometimes we forget about this. If you're using water or a windshield washer solvent that is not rated for freezing temperatures, drain the reservoir. Your next step is going to be to open the two sprayer flush valves located at your suction nozzle. At this time, make sure you drain all water from your washdown hose and remove all tips from around the unit and store the nozzles in a safe, warm location. The last step is going to be to open the drains on the water spray manifold. One is located on the driver's side and one is located on the passenger side. Once you have done so, your truck is now winterized and ready for storage for the cold weather.